Good morning. My name is Sandro Bonazzola. I'm a manager working for Red Hat, and within the oVirt project, I'm managing Relay's node and integration teams. And I'm the oVirt community liaison for Red Hat. On behalf of the oVirt communities around the globe and of the organizing committee, I want to welcome all of you to this first oVirt online conference. 2020 has been a challenging year for everyone, and I appreciate you found the time to join us today in this virtual event. I'm personally missing the human interaction I was used to in our previous conferences, but I hope we managed to provide you and us a good enough space to meet and exchange information and stories around oVirt. oVirt is a free open source virtualization solution for your entire enterprise. It provides a rich web-based user interface for both administrators and non-admin users, integrated management of host, storage, and network configuration, live migration of virtual machine and disks between host and storage, high availability of virtual machines in the event of host failure. The project is governed by a board with the role of coordinating and helping ensure smooth running of the oVirt project. The board also facilitates a form for cross-project architectural coordination and communication between projects to resolve relay schedule or integration issues. When we met last year in Rome, the oVirt board included members from Red Hat, Cisco, Canonical, and IBM. During this challenging year, board members changed a bit. I would like to thank Scott Moser, who left the board this year, for his past contributions, and I want to wish good luck to Michael Enesco in his new role. So, as of today, oVirt board has a representative from IBM, Red Hat, and Caltech. As a project, oVirt couldn't exist without many other open source projects. Limiting the view to the ones most relevant for oVirt, we can mention CentOS, which provides an enterprise-level operating system, Cluster, which provides a shared reliable storage, QEMU, KVM, and libvirt, providing the infrastructure for running virtual machine and so on. We will get to the project later when we'll talk about features we introduced in our latest release, oVirt 4.4. For those who already seen a similar slide in previous year conference, you will notice a few projects disappeared and a few others appeared. We'll get into them in a minute. For those that are approaching oVirt for the first time, the oVirt project positions itself within the hybrid cloud infrastructure software, providing the needed pieces to run your own hybrid cloud. And within the infrastructure, it is handling the virtualization role, just between the bare metal and private cloud. As you probably noticed in previous slides, Fedora project that used to be mentioned in previous conference is not there anymore. If you have followed the oVirt project for a few releases, you already know oVirt has struggled to keep the pace with the fast innovation cycles Fedora project is following. Back in September 2019, CentOS project launched CentOS Stream as a rolling preview of future RHEL kernel and features, providing an upstream development platform for ecosystem developers that sits between Fedora and RHEL. Since then, the oVirt project tried to keep the software working on Fedora, CentOS Stream, and RHEL and CentOS, but it became quickly evident the organization lacked resources to keep the project running on three platforms. Further, a user survey shows that oVirt users strongly prefer using oVirt on CentOS and RHEL. So, with Fedora 30 reached its end of life, the oVirt project has decided to stop trying to keep the pace with this amazing platform, focusing on stabilizing the software code base on RHEL and CentOS. But let's have a look at oVirt as a software. This time, I want to present you the architecture of the software or showing you how the interface looks like. You will see the oVirt interface several times today in the other presentations. If you are interested in getting more details on the software architecture, I recommend you to visit the oVirt website and read more about there. This time, I want to focus on what's new in oVirt 4.4 for everyone out there who haven't updated yet. Compared to oVirt 4.3, the whole software stack has been updated, starting from the underlying operating system. oVirt 4.4 now requires CentOS 8.2 or newer. We'll see in next presentations that CentOS 7 or equivalent based nodes can still be managed by oVirt Engine 4.4 in cluster level 4.2 or 4.3 while upgrading the whole infrastructure. Coming with the operating system, also the virtualization stack has been updated from QEMU KVM to 12 to advanced virtualization stack, which currently ships QEMU KVM 4.2. The whole oVirt project source code has been refactored for running on Java 11 and Python 3.6 to match the default version provided by the underlying distribution. With the massive refactoring of the code, functionalities that were deprecated in previous releases have been dropped. We dropped support for cluster level prior to 4.2. This means that you will need to ensure your data center is at least at 4.2 cluster level in order to be able to update. APA and SDK version 3 support, which has deprecated in past version, has been dropped too. If you have scripts you developed for your own task, you need to update them to work with 4.4. I want just to remind that Software Development Kit version 4 was already there in previous oVirt releases, so you can update your code before updating to oVirt 4.4. oVirt Shell has been dropped as well with the removal of the version 3 of the API. And oVirt OS Deploy has been replaced by Ansible-based code. If you relied on oVirt OS Deploy functionalities for installing packages on the host, you'll need to change your tooling for using the new Ansible-based deploy system. The OpenStack Neutron agent cannot be configured by oVirt anymore. It should be configured by Trepolo instead. Last but not least, the automated deployment of the oVirt metric store has been removed. It will still be possible to send data to an Elasticsearch instance, but for 4.4, the project developed a much simpler solution based on oVirt Data Warehouse and Grafana. Since we just mentioned the removal of the version 3 of the API, in oVirt 4.4, I want to remind you that oVirt tasks can be automated leveraging Ansible roles and modules, or using one of the existing SDK for your preferred language. Okay, we have lost some functionalities, but we also gained from the rebase. Here are a few features oVirt could implement thanks to the underlying software stack rebase. We gained an easier network management and configuration flexibility with Network Manager. VMs are now based on a more modern Q35 chipset with legacy CPUs and UEFI firmware. We can now support direct pass-through of localhost to disk. We got live migration improvement for high-performance guests. We have now 4-key block disk support. It's only for file-based storage for now. iSCSI and Fibre Channel do not support 4-key disk yet. You can now export a VM to a data domain and edit it floating disk. Ansible Runner is integrated within the oVirt engine, enabling more detailed monitoring of playbooks executed from the engine. And in oVirt 4.4.1, the maximum memory size for 64-bit VMs is now 6 terabytes. And this limit is also applied to VMs in 4.2 and 4.3 cluster level 4x86-64. These relays introduce a new monitoring solution that provides a user interface to oVirt data warehouse collected data using Grafana. This allows admin to track inventory, monitor performance and capacity trends, and easily identify and troubleshoot resource issues. Grafana is installed and configured during engine setup and includes pre-built dashboards that are based on the data collected by the oVirt engine history PostgreSQL data warehouse database. You will hear about other features introduced in oVirt 4.4 during the conference. Stay tuned. Now, entering the part of this presentation I prefer, because oVirt is not just a piece of software, it's also your stories. oVirt is a global community who counts nearly 1,600 people in the main Facebook group. But it's also a reality of local communities around the globe, which are growing fast. The increment shown here is compared to November 2019. I'm happy that community leads joined the organizing committee preparing this conference. I would also like to welcome oVirt Philippines, our newest local community in the broader oVirt global community. I'm interested in hearing the stories behind the great increment in Myanmar and India, and maybe more interested in hearing from Korean community about the stories that led to the small decrease there. And communities have stories, stories that sometimes had to face quick responses to unforeseen threats like COVID-19 pandemic we had to fight with this year altogether. I will showcase one brought to oVirt IRC channel by Fabian Kjolds from the IT and solution company. I will let you to go over the details reading the slide later on, but they renewed the entire IT of an hospital in a bit more than 2 weeks as a response to the emergency. And they chose oVirt as fast, easy, reliable, and complete infrastructure to sell thin client they developed for supporting nurses and doctors in their daily work. But there are also stories we'll never hear because they'll be reported elsewhere. oVirt project has several downstreams, other companies rebranding oVirt project and providing their respective customers assistance and support. This year, we have a new entry. Open Euler project started to work on porting oVirt to ARM processor within Open Euler Virtualization Special Interest Group. I'm looking forward to their patches to be sent to the oVirt project. On the oVirt website, you can find a few featured stories from the past years under the community section. A thing that I like to repeat in this conference is that the first oVirt user is the oVirt project itself. In oVirt project data center, we're running it on 9 data centers, 15 storage domain, 11 host for 160 AVMs. If you want to share your story, feel free to open a ticket on the GitHub issue tracker for the oVirt website, and we'll help you publishing it. Looking at user mailing list traffic for the past quarter, I noticed a trend of new users from various universities, laboratories, libraries, and public sector. You will hear today one talk from them, Paul Staniford from Leeds Beckett University, which will tell us about using oVirt to provide a free open source solution VDI to teach cybersecurity in a sandboxed realistic environment to remote students. You will also hear another talk from Dr. Arman Karatian from the Leibniz Institute for Astrophysics Potsdam, who will present us a talk titled Microservices Towards to Reproducible Science, Combining oVirt and OKD. Last, if you're looking for a way to contribute to the project, we have a very strong community of users, experienced sysadmin and integrators that quickly reply to your question, helping to resolve issues you may face while deploying or running your data center. But the projects also need developers, translators, testers to continue developing new features and provide users the best software for running enterprise virtualization. Also, as I mentioned, the oVirt project is running its own data center, which is getting almost 6 years old. In order to keep the infrastructure up, we'll need new hardware. If you are interested, you'll find the specs of the needed hardware on the oVirt website. And as you may have guessed, I like stories. So if you can share yours, let me know. And there are other ways to contribute to community. Just joining the discussion on the mailing list or file bugs, help localizing. You can also just promote oVirt by tweet, blog, or at the coffee machine, or more deeper, organizing workshop or meetup. You can also join surveys we are sending out to user mailing list from time to time, or share how you're using oVirt, either in a user story, in a case study, or just saying it in the web mailing list. And if you have derivative work, either on the client side or backup restore, you can share them. Or you can just update or fix the documentation on the website. And as I said, you can still donate hardware. Thank you, everyone, and enjoy today's conference.